Hi, I'm Sreevatsan. This is my 7.5 years old boy, Bossy. I bought Bossy through my friend. He was 30 days old when I bought him. From then, he's been part of my family, and we literally love to have him in our family each and every day. And he's given us all the comfort, love, affection, which probably I would have not got elsewhere. So he showed us what's love and how friendly you can be, and what to let go and what to have in your life. So there are little things that we have learned from this guy, and he taught us, and that's what this is. My boy is. I want to tell something about the health issues which we faced initially. Initially, when I bought him as a pup, he had a little bit of skin issues, after which we treated him, and later on he had other issues like rashes in the legs, which came again. It was skin issues. Again, we had treated. So any signs which we see in his external body or any internal issues, we do recognize. We definitely take him to the vet right away. Most common things which we faced with him is there would be any kind of a body movement, or he'll be lying down flat, which means it's directly pinpointing that he is in some kind of an issue. There's a health issue. When a dog doesn't move around, or he's lying down at one place, or he vomits, when there's a continuous vomit, even once he vomits, we have to take your dog straight away to the vet. It could be any kind of an infection or anything else which we not that the vet has to check. And I would suggest everyone who wants to have a dog, please don't neglect that your dog is healthy always. It's good to have a health checkup every 6 months, as we humans, we do take it, and have a complete body checkup done. So right from blood count, liver, heart, kidneys, everything, have those complete tests done, and that's probably 6 months once. Have a scan done at least a year once, so that we can know what's happening internally. If there's any tumor, or is any mass, or is any cancer, something, and have an X-ray too done to know their if there's any issues with, like, say arthritis, which they may face at the further stages. So I advise that it's better to identify the initial stage itself and have it diagnosed, so that they don't suffer their later stages. Okay, and with regards to food habits, my first suggestion is give them a home food. Don't go with the pedigree, Royal Canin. I'm sorry if I had to name it, but don't go with external foods. Give them a home rich foods like carrots, mushrooms, pumpkins, beans. These are rich in vitamins, which gives them a good nutrition. And home foods is the best food for dogs. Weekly once, give them probably any non-vegetarian. Let that be not of a flesh, right? Like a liver, a smashed liver, mix it with food. Avoid carbohydrates, which are not that good for dogs, but try feeding him more of veggies. Eggs will be a good supplement for them, which is rich in protein. That is one thing, and that's about it. And one thing is, I just wanted to tell you guys is, dogs are not dangerous at all until you raise them right. They are the friendliest creatures, and everyone should have them in the family to know what they are. Thank you.